Hi there, welcome to another video on the Olivetti ECR 7190 and 7790. In this video, we're going through some of the programming that you can update on the machine, so the department names and the receipt header or footer. So to access the program mode, you just need to choose the mode switch, take it over to PRG for programming, and in here, all the different sections you can access, so whether that's departments, whether that's header or footer. And to do that, all you do is using the #NS button. If you press it once, you'll see that it's moved to the PLU programming part, and if you keep pressing it, it will move through the different sections. So pressing it again, departments, that's clerks or cashiers if you want to use them and set them up. We'll cover that in a different video. FC is foreign currency, so not that often used, to be perfectly honest. HD is headers, which is 6 lines of text, and the footer, which is 4 lines. Pressing it once more, you'll get back to 0, which basically means you're outside of programming, and you could turn the mode button back to off or registration, wherever you need to go. To actually update any of the data, we'll go and do a department first. So again, we're coming back to using the #NS button, and we're on to DP01. So what we're actually being able to do here is update department 1, which is this button here, to whichever name we want to. So what you actually do is using the 0 to 9 keys, you'll see that all the letters are on there. Also available online is the full character key, so you'll see where all the numbers are, and also some of the symbols if you need to use them, which quite often you do in like your header if you're putting your address in there, so you'll need like a building number. And what you'll see is here's the actual keys and how many times you press it to access like number one. So if you wanted one, you're using the number one keypad and you're pressing it 8 times to get to that. And just to demonstrate that, if you take a look here, if I press number one 8 times, you'll see there I've pressed it 8 times and I've got a symbol of 1. Okay, but what we're going to do is we'll just update department 1 to food and department 2 to drink. So just using the keypad now. If you're in this scenario like here where I need to put 2 of the same letter from number 6, if you press the enter button, it'll actually move and I can actually then carry on doing the next letter. So food. When you're finished editing that department name, you just press the check button to save that. And you'll see here it's moved to department 2. Also, if you just push up the paper, you'll see that department 1 is now renamed to food. So in department 2, we're going to name that as drinks. Again, using the check button just to save that. So we've finished updating the 2 departments. What we'll do now is we'll move on to the footer and we'll update that. In the standard settings of the machine, it comes with a default header and footer. So on the header, it says your receipt, thank you, and your footer, have a nice day, please come again. So what we're going to do is just update the have a nice day, please come again. We'll just put a return policy in there. So using the #NS, we want to go to footer, so FT1. Where that text actually is in line 2 and 3. So we just need to use the department button to go to footer, line 2. I'm just going to put in there refunds within 30 days only. The one thing to note is it doesn't auto-center the text that you put in there. So if you just start typing, it's all going to be left aligned, or you can work out how many spaces you need to put in at the front of the message just to get it into the center. So I've worked that out for this purpose, and I need like 5 spaces on this line to get it into the center. So on the 0 button, there's actually an SP, which basically means space. So pressing that 5 times, and then I'm going to start putting in my message. Put another space in there. So I'm going to put returns within on the first line, save that. Here I need 6 spaces. So I need number three this time. So again, I just need to press that a few times. And so it's actually eight times and I get a number three. The zero actually is behind the double zero. Oh, I went too far there. So if you did go too far, there's a delete button here. And I finished that line. So again, press the check button. I finished actually programming. So you can use the \ns just to get back to zero, or you can just use a total. And you'll see here we're back to zero, which means we can turn the mode button back to registration. And we'll just get rid of that for now. Just put a transaction through. And now that should come up with a new department name. Do department two as well. So now what you'll see here on the receipt, I've got the department food and drink, and I've also updated the footer to say returns within 30 days only. Okay, hope that helps. Thanks for watching.